Thank you, Matt Hagg, for the intro to this podcast. That's our Christmas mix, you may remember from last year. This is our Christmas-themed episode, a little bit, kind of, not really, but we do have Christmas topics, but we'll get to those later. I'm John Rowe, your host, joined by my co-hosts.
Lantz Kilcoyne.
And Tyler Felco Schott.
Yes, we're back. We took kind of a week off, I think. The listeners
you
won't notice.
You took a week off. I didn't take any.
I know. Lantz wanted to record, and I had worked all weekend, and I was tired. And
it was my birthday last week.
Yeah, we didn't go. We didn't have a party, though.
No, Tyler's 31st.
Yeah, my 31st birthday. That's not true.
Yeah, he's 31.
I'm
years
31.
Young. Yes, holy crap. Exactly. I think out of all the people, in our, you probably wouldn't be the one mistaken to be 31. It'd probably be me.
I look like a child as well.
Or Lantz with a mustache. We have to get that photo.
Yeah.
That photo will be in the episode. I'll get that for my brother.
Just with one mustache?
Well, I'll take a, next time I shave, I'll get some better photos.
Okay. Get a better mustache photo. Because Lantz said it aged you considerably.
Oh, yeah.
Put on a flannel and a stocking cap.
I looked like Captain Lou from Rescue Me.
Oh, jeez. No good.
Not a very good reference, though.
No.
Yeah, what do you call it?
Tom Selleck would be a good mustache.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good mustache, but other than that, there's never a good mustache.
I don't look like Tom Selleck.
No, most mustache, people so. Don't look like Tom Selleck.
Yeah, your mic was turned off for all of that, Tyler.
What? What? How did you not catch that before?
Because I could hear your voice because you're really loud. So I'm sorry, listeners, for the intro on that.
That's why I could not hear my voice in my headset. That
yeah.
makes sense.
Well, I think it was turned off because we had switched mics around, and now we're back after a week hiatus, so things were a little off. But anyway, yeah, because we had four people, and we had to turn Matt's mic off when he left.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That happened.
Because he left in the middle of the episode in a huff.
Yeah.
He got into an argument with Tyler.
Yeah, he
Running with Scissors is now disbanded. They didn't put an episode out this week.
No, we did.
Oh, really?
We did before
Silent
I came
release.
Here. That's not true at all. I was going to. But
I
couldn't find it on my computer.
Oh, shit.
Matt's just finding this out right now.
Ah, yeah.
So,
he'll hear this on Sunday when
yeah,
we release tomorrow.
He's probably going to kill me when he hears
it. I thought it was
that.
You with a Matt puppet, and like the Matt puppet is talking back. In the fashion that Matt would.
Yeah, Matt's not actually
you do
real.
A whole ventriloquist.
Oh, no.
Bit.
Well, Matt's actually another one of my puppets.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
He is.
Don't look up the Keegan-Michael Key episode picture.
Yeah.
That's just an elaborate puppet.
That's an elaborate puppet. That's like from, you know, being John Malkovich. It's one of those.
Well, you're a puppeteer, so
I'm
you worked hard on that.
Yeah, it took me about 4 years before I came to college. I wanted to make a college roommate friend.
And I see. So you could live alone, but say you had a roommate?
But then it started to really get out of hand because when I took a shower with my girlfriend one time, my puppet just got really upset about it and bleached my entire bathtub.
Wow. That's,
a puppet did that, right?
Wow.
It's crazy shit.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Are we opening the sex script here?
No, I wasn't.
Is this a real story?
I was. Yeah, that was a real story.
So
I didn't have sex with her in there, though. I didn't have sex with her in that bathtub. Many other bathtubs were
But they just assumed you did, and they got really mad at you and bleached everything?
Well, my puppet Matt walked across the door, and he heard me and my girlfriend in there, and just talking and being stupid. And it freaked him out so much that he decided to, like, bleach the bathtub and, like, I don't know. Yeah.
That's messed up.
What was messed up? The fact that he bleached the bathtub or the fact that I took a shower with my girlfriend? Which one? Because I've heard...
It is a communal shower.
Yeah.
But you guys weren't banging.
No, we weren't banging in that shower. But I did bang in my previous shower.
Wow.
And
wait. In that shower? Just not that time?
No, not that shower.
Oh, okay.
I did in one of the... You know, there was like six people that lived in like
Stevie dorms.
Yeah,
at Edgewood,
and we shared like two showers.
Six people shared two showers.
We had sex in that one.
Ugh.
Yeah,
that's a gross shower.
Yeah, I tried. Yeah, it was pretty gross.
Were you afraid of falling and like hitting something on that fire?
I never wanted to have sex in a shower because I would be afraid of dying.
It's hard to keep it up in the shower.
I'm sure.
At the time, we were wearing a lot of I was wearing condoms and shit at the time.
Oh, okay. So you were having a really
hard
time.
Yeah, so it was, like, super hard to, like, wear a condom in the shower.
It was like being in having a coat in a rainstorm.
Yeah.
But actually...
It is. It's like wearing a poncho.
Actually wearing a poncho in a rainstorm. So
yeah.
It was no good.
But, I mean, I think that was one of the reasons that led up to her getting on birth control, actually, was because we wanted to, like, have sex in the shower.
Well, if you're on birth control, then you can go anywhere. You don't need a condom.
Yeah.
According to Tyler.
Yeah, and having and having sex on a boardwalk and like other shit like that.
Jesus. That's too... The crypt is closed.
Yeah, yeah. I wasn't even going to bring it up, but then it kind of like... I just easily glazed over it, and you were like, right, Lantz? Lantz is nodding his head here.
Well, I wanted to bring the crypt back for the listeners. Mm.
It's okay. The crypt can stay closed for a while.
All right, we can stay closed. Lantz, how's your week?
It's been all right. I don't know what else to say.
You didn't see a dead guy?
I wasn't, no.
Oh, that's right! That's right.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Body count was at zero. And remain there.
Is that the name of a band? Body Count?
That is a band, yeah.
Ugh, of course they are.
It's an Ice-T metal band, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's that band.
Body Count's in the house, motherfucker.
Oh, jeez.
The first track. It's hilarious.
That's no good.
I know too much about that band. Hmm.
Speaking of Ice-T, didn't his wife just cheat on him, by the way?
I'm sure. I mean,
yeah. Coco?
Yeah. She has giant boobs, by the way. Jeez, that woman has ungodly boobs.
She was manufactured by a Hasbro company.
Was she? Okay, that makes sense.
They took an average-looking woman and they Barbied her.
That makes perfect sense.
Is her name Coco?
Yeah, it's Coco.
Coco Cabana.
She doesn't even have a real name.
Coco,
see?
Beware.
She's not even a
different
real person.
Different person entirely.
But she, like, there's pictures of her with this other rapper guy. I don't know, like A Hizzle or whatever they call him.
Yeah.
I don't even think I'm making a name up. I think his name actually is A Hizzle.
Huh.
And he was like.
Is that like
her?
Short for A Hole?
It might be. A-hizzle? I don't know.
Or A House?
But he's like, I've heard rumors that he was like, he's one of those rappers that's a wannabe. And Ice-T has like real rap. You know, he has like a
real.
Well,
Ice-T was like he's a published rapper.
Yeah.
He's released albums.
And he's actually robbed banks and shit. Like,
yeah, you got to do that to be a rapper.
But before he was a rapper. And this guy.
I think
he
maybe robbed a person on the street, but maybe not a bank.
On a podcast he was on a while back ago, he said because of statute of limitations, he's now allowed to say what he did. And he robbed a bank at one time.
Him and Danny Trejo pulled a heist. 1986.
Yeah, watch out here.
I know. I'm sorry, John.
You have the shortest headphone cord.
You know, don't call my headphone cord short, okay?
Right.
It's not my fault that I was given that way.
Yeah, well.
I've worked really hard to make it longer and to do stuff to make it
I would
stretch.
Like to also mention it also has the thinnest cord of all of ours, too.
It's not the thinnest, John.
So, you're losing on both counts.
It's
here.
Not the long or the thickness of the cord.
It's
how you use it and how well you can hear things.
Crypt closed again.
That was what? You took the wrong way. I was just saying facts.
All right. Well, we got... Maybe I'll just start right in with this Christmas stuff. So I know you guys might be...
Or do we want to talk about my thing? Do we want to do that later?
Let's do your thing first. Let's
I want to hear about your thing.
Yeah.
So I have...
Crypt closed.
Prepared a trilogy.
A trilogy. Much like The Hobbit and Unexpected.
So is this is this going to be overly long and boring? Like anything Peter Jackson does?
Oh,
or?
Yeah.
It's a trilogy of dreams that I had this last week and a half.
Oh, sexy.
All right.
Were you naked in them?
So we are going into dream time.
I would like to mention that when Lantz said this, I had a crazy dream last night that I will get into as an addendum. I think I teased it to Lantz.
Maybe I'll
before.
Do one, you do yours, and I'll do the other two.
We'll see. It'll come in organically.
And I don't dream, so this is all good for me.
You dream.
No, I don't. I'm
you
a robot.
You just don't remember them.
I'm a puppet.
Everyone
I don't dream.
Everyone dreams.
So, one dream, I don't know which one to start off. I'll start off with maybe my least.
The lighter?
Yeah.
I don't want to follow the light
I'm going to have a good punchline in the third one. I'll save the best for last. But, okay, so this was like 2 nights ago. I went to sleep.
Eventful dream week.
And I had a dream. Yeah, I know, right? And I had a dream that I was like in a church and... I was like, so yeah, you know, I've been like the priest here for a while now. And
you said this?
Yes.
So you're the priest.
So
you're the
priest. Like kind of, as I'm talking to someone, and then I look down and I'm wearing the collar and stuff. Like I am the priest. And I'm just really realizing this while I'm already going on about being the priest.
Yeah.
And I'm like.
Judas priest.
And they're like, oh, okay. Like, and they, you know, they kind of say like, well, I'll see you later. And then I go to, like, the front of the church, right, and they're all looking at me, the people in there, in the pews, and I just realize I don't know what to say.
Oh, you were in front of everyone. Who are you speaking to when you said I'm
the congregation? This is the top day.
This was your homily?
I was like,
I've been the priest.
Having a chit-chat.
Got it.
That was over.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there.
I go to the front. to do the mass or something. And I'm like, I don't know what to do. and so I start stumbling around and just reading stuff off of a book in front of me, but I'm not really making sense because it's a dream.
Yeah.
And then I remember this old lady in the front is like, he doesn't know what he's doing. And I'm like, no.
She calls you out.
I think a psychologist could see a lot of parallels in this dream.
Maybe the other two will get you more. That was pretty much where that ended.
It's a pretty freaky dream.
Yeah, that's
what
weird,
kind of
right?
congregation
there's layers
was this?
To that.
It must have been. It was a Catholic church.
Yeah, was it
I'm
Catholic?
Assuming?
I assume. I mean,
oh, so it wasn't like it was that specific or anything. It was just like very vague kind of
right.
thing.
I just it was like a podium and pews.
Was there a was there a crucifix with Jesus hanging on the cross?
I didn't see any detail like
all
Jesus.
Because that's a Catholic church.
That dream
that. I just remember being like pumped about like, yeah, I'm the priest. And then all of a sudden like,
I got to do shit now.
I'm the priest. Oh, God.
That dream seems kind of like akin to like, you know, going to a class and having a report to do.
Exactly. Oh, I have that dream so often.
Do you really?
Oh, where it's just like, oh shit, oh, I gotta go to this class and I didn't do my homework, and I show up to the class and they're like, they don't mention it, and I feel guilty the whole time, and I like have to go to another class that I'm late for always.
How often do you guys remember your dreams?
Like, lately I've been obviously a lot more than usual.
Yeah, quite a bit.
Oh, I barely ever do. I only have like four stories.
It's kind of interesting though when you think about this. So like, this thing's called lucid dreaming that people are really into. That's where you can, like, control your dreams a little bit.
Yeah.
And there's, like, all sorts of eye goggles and shit you can get where it's, like, shows, like, flashing red lights. So if you see flashing red lights in your dream, you're aware of it. So you wake up in the dream, basically.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. I actually read that the easiest way to do lucid dreaming is just to write down dreams so you remember them more, so you get more used to thinking about dreams.
Oh.
So when you're in the dream, you'll, like, snap out of it, and you can do anything. Can like fly and shit. Yeah,
I've heard of. Certain,
it's happened to me a couple times, and it's crazy.
I've heard certain pills you can take to help you like be able to have more lucid dreams and stuff too, and all that.
Yeah,
I don't know. It sounds like a cool thing, but really, what the only thing that I can think about using it for is getting banged in my dreams and or superpowers.
And I used it. It's great.
Oh, good.
It's a great triumph.
Who was it? Halle Berry? Did you Halle Berry?
Yeah, I'm not a Halle Berry fan.
No, really?
The nipples are too small.
I'm okay with that, though. I'm okay with that.
They're like tiny dots.
She's one of the few famous girls I've seen naked.
Really?
Yeah,
I've
because
seen a lot of famous girls naked.
Well, I mean, that I want to see naked. Like, I didn't want to see Meg Ryan naked, but we all saw that one together.
Oh, yeah, we saw that. We had In the Cut. Look it up. She's old, but she still got a little bit of it. So,
Anyways, back to...
Mark Ruffalo eats her out a lot.
Oh, he does. Yeah. That's right.
He's right up in
there.
That must have been real. There's no way they could have shot that.
That movie's name is just disgusting in its own right.
He was in the cut the whole time.
In the cut. What is that one movie that we saw a long time ago where the girl's like super hot with like E. McGregor? Or...
Tilda Swinton? Oh, no. you're thinking of Emily Mortimer.
Yeah, and what movie was that?
That was so hot. Young Adam, I think. Yeah, she's really hot.
Oh, God. Super amazing boobs in it. Ugh.
Yeah, and she had Bush, so it was great.
Yeah, this has been Mr. Skin. Thank you for listening.
Yeah, just check out Young Adam. Fast forward to the part where there's a train station, and then you'll see this scene.
But, I mean, about dreams, though, are we supposed to be examining these dreams and breaking them down for you?
I think, yeah, we're talking a little bit about it.
Okay.
Okay. So
I don't want to get to my crazy one because that's going to trump anything you're going to say next.
Okay, here's my second dream.
I want you to build up to it.
My second dream... I've been watching a lot of BBC animal stuff lately.
Yeah, I know you have. Eric has told me that, like, he'll be in his room, like, playing a game or studying, and you'll just, like, bust him and be like, hey, dude, so you know this falcon in, like, Australia? He's fucking crazy, man. He's like, you've become, like, fucking David Attenborough. Like,
is this
I told him about the falcon that had, or the hawk that had, like, a gigantic wingspan.
Yeah, yeah.
And they said it can attack a young antelope.
Yeah.
Like, on, you know, just walking around, and death from above comes at you.
Yeah, golden eagles get, like, 7-8 foot wingspans.
It tackles
enormous.
Them, and it just starts... ripping them apart right there, man.
I'm so happy we're humans and not like a fucking prairie dog or something.
Sadly, they did not have footage of that. But
yeah, it's probably pretty rare.
If Richard Attenborough said it, it's true. So. But Or David Attenborough.
It's
David Attenborough.
Not Richard, the actor.
Okay, let's get to the sexy dream of yours.
The second dream, though.
Are you naked in this dream?
No.
God damn it.
I'm falling asleep watching a documentary on grizzly bears.
Oh, no!
Whoa.
This is bad McGumbas.
And I had this dream. This is a shorter one because I woke up so soon after it.
This made me think of a dream I had.
I'm riding a three-wheel bicycle.
Oh, I thought you were going to say grizzly bear, and I was like, this is the best dream
ever. They have three-wheel bicycles?
Yes.
A tricycle, if you will.
except a bike, though.
Really? Okay.
With a basket on the back. Like, I used to have one of those.
Okay, okay, okay.
And I'm riding around this lake. There's like a walkway around a lake. And I'm, like, just minding my own business and riding a three-wheel bike around the lake. And all of a sudden, there's a grizzly bear in front of me. And it gets up on its hind legs and it roars at me. And I'm like, oh, my God. And so I think here's the hilariousness of it for me. Instead of, like, getting off the bike and just running or whatever, because it's a slow bike. It's a three-wheel bike.
Yeah, it's not fast.
I take the wide turn.
You do the wide turn?
The wide turn.
Oh, okay.
Where it takes forever to turn around, it feels like. And I get back on the path the other way, and I'm going around the lake, and I'm like, oh, God.
And then you look in the rearview mirror, and it says, objects may appear closer. It's like Jurassic Park.
Like, there's a grizzly bear. And then I look up, and there's another grizzly
bear. So either way you went, you were fucked. Ooh, there's that's symbolism bears. Right there.
Regular Timothy Treadwell here.
And they got in close, and then I woke up, and I was terrified.
I've not had horrific dreams like that.
You were
before.
On an unconventional vehicle on a path you haven't been on before.
Yeah.
Where on either way you went, you were fucked. And that's kind of a symbolic shit going on right there. Like an unconventional vehicle that
So far, I'm not prepared for things, and I'm fucked either way I go.
Yeah.
So that going
I'll have to find my dream journal. I have a dream journal.
Do you really?
Yeah, I do.
Well, you guys are on top of this.
I'd like to write them down because they're hilarious. No, but, okay, so this reminded me of a dream I had once.
Okay.
So I fell asleep. This was back when I was in high school. I fell asleep on the couch after school watching Pokemon on TV.
Oh, God, that could fuck you up.
That dream was intense. It was like Team Rocket was, like, fucking shit up. And that I kind of, like, had, like, the dream where, like, it was, like, following the episode of the plot. You know what I mean? Like, the entire, like, all the lines from the episode were feeding into my head, and I was, like, making scenes up. And I, like, woke up, and it was, like, exactly the scene in my brain that was on the screen, and I was like, oh, my God.
What was the chick's name in Team Rocket?
Jessie?
Oh, she was hot.
Yeah, she was kind of hot.
Yeah, she was hot.
Weirdly hot. Anyway.
Hot in a bad,
formative,
like, I'm not a
childhood
good person,
female character. But, no, I had another dream that involved Pokemon, though, but this isn't that dream. Where I don't remember what happened. I couldn't find my Pokemon. Like, I couldn't find my Pokeball. This is like I was in middle school, so I was playing Pokemon and shit. I couldn't find my Pokeball. And, like, I had a Pikachu, and he kept fucking everything up. He was, like, tearing shit up and, like, ruining everything. And then, like, Bill Clinton was there. Okay. And I got in, like, trouble, and I was, like, went to, like, trial because my Pikachu had fucked everything up.
You are really fucked when Bill Clinton is the prosecutor.
Oh, I know. he wasn't the prosecutor. He was, like, the judge.
Oh, God.
Oh, Jesus.
It was, like, the judicator.
So you couldn't find your Pokeball, and Bill Clinton came to...
No. I couldn't find my Pokeball, and it turned out, like, Pikachu had been fucked. It was a long time.
Okay.
I have it written down somewhere.
Okay. But, this is an epic dream is what
it is. Yeah, it was a long dream. And then I found Pikachu, and he had fucked everything up. And I got in a lot of trouble. I had to go to court. And then, like, it turned out, there was, like, and then they read the Pokedex, and it said, Pikachus often can mess a lot of things up when they are left alone. It's like, oh, so, and then Bill Clinton's like, so you see, it's not your fault. This is just their nature. And then I got let off because Bill Clinton is awesome and knows Pokemon for some reason. It was amazing. Oh, that was a crazy dream. That just made me think of that.
Okay, my final dream.
Yep.
Ooh, drum roll, please.
John is in this one.
Oh, whoa. Was John naked in this one?
No.
God, good.
Would you do?
I just want to make sure before we get into the story that it's not going to whip open the sex script. I'm being prepared here. Anyways, go on, buddy.
Anyway, so I'm sitting in a lobby of, like, a movie theater. A nice one, not one that I've been to before.
Yeah, so like a good...
I'm sitting on one of those chairs that's a couch without a backing, you know?
Yeah.
Just like a big cushion
thing. Yep.
And I'm sitting there. And there's screens showing stuff, like a movie
theater. Trailers and shit.
And you walk in.
Yeah?
And you're like, hey, what's going on? And I'm like, hey, just sitting here like I was going to go to the movies. And you're like, yeah, I know. Like, it's the premiere. And I'm like, what? and he's like, our movie's playing. And
what?
And I'm like, what? And so, and I'm like, no, I'm going to go see something else.
That's so you.
And then you say like, no, we have to go. It's the premiere. Like, it's what we've like worked for. And so I get up and I'm like, you mean like we're really watching our movie? And so we go to the movie.
Really, John? Yeah. Our movie? Yeah, Lantz, let's go.
We go to the theater.
Yeah.
And we're sitting there. And what I end up seeing is almost like a 7-minute trailer.
Yeah.
In my mind. Like, it's not a full movie.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it's longer than a trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
And basically, like, you were the main character.
Of course.
This is what Hollywood has thrown its money to.
Yeah, yeah, to me. Acting in a movie.
This was a coming-of-age comedy drama.
Wow.
Where we were all in, like, grad school or college. Like, we're too old, though, to be in just college.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, must have been a grad school something.
Yeah, post-graduation stuff.
And I was, like, the third main character.
Okay.
And
who
was
the second?
The main character... you were the main character.
Yeah.
The second main character was a redheaded guy I'd never seen before.
Oh, what? Adam Ham.
Is it Adam? No. Adam's not redheaded, though.
And he had all the, like... I remember the scene where I was watching it, and, like you had the funny scene.
Yeah.
And then I had a scene where, like, I think someone left the number two guy, like, this girl.
Yeah.
And I gave her, like, wisdom. And
wow, I want to see this film.
And you should really go with what your heart, you know? Like, that kind of
stuff. Sounds like some shitty dialogue I'd write.
It was pretty bad. I'm trying to sleep while I'm doing this, so
yeah,
it's
yeah,
not.
Yeah.
And so anyway, and then the plot twist was the redhead guy, like, shoots himself.
What? This sounds like something I write.
And he's like, and then I say to you, like, or vice versa, I can't remember which, but like, he's gone! Like, now we have to be better friends. Like, we have to be better friends because we lost a wheel or something.
Yeah, we're no longer a three-wheeled bicycle running away from some bears. Yeah. We're a two-wheeled bicycle.
We're a two-wheeled bike.
We got to stand up on our own.
And that was the movie that I saw.
Oh, wow. So. That sounds spectacular.
So the third dream is basically you just watching a movie?
Yes.
Wow. Our movie.
What does that mean?
That's kind of crazy to see. You saw yourself
on
screen?
Dude.
That's creepy.
And not only that.
That doesn't happen to me often.
Not only that, I had different facial hair than I did at that time.
Yeah. That's creepy.
Whoa, yeah, John, you just blew my mind. I'm thinking about it. Yeah, seeing yourself in a dream, but
it's
not
weird,
looking
right?
at it.
Yeah.
That's
wow.
what also blew
that
my mind, was seeing myself on a screen in that.
Well, that's
so
pretty
that
crazy.
That was that dream.
Nice. I had a really weird dream recently.
Oh, God. Here we go. Were you naked?
No, somebody else was.
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
So I don't know what's going on in my... So I was in this apartment. I don't really remember a lot of it because I didn't write it down. You got to write it down so you remember it. That's the key to a dream journal. But anyway, I just remember Brendan Fraser. I think they were shooting a porno in my apartment.
Oh, yeah, of course Brendan Fraser.
And Brendan Fraser was in this.
Yeah.
And he was
Makes
just
sense.
Stark naked. And he had the longest dick I have ever seen.
Well, was the thickness equal
it
to the longness?
It was a fucking
just
like baseball bat.
Oh, Jesus
taking
Christ.
A drink right
I'm just telling it like it is. It was really fucked up. And I remember calling a lot of people saying, why is he naked in my apartment? And I called up friends. I was like, what's going on here? And then I woke up. It was just really weird.
Maybe you should
keep
that
one
to yourself.
I know, right?
The dream was just you walking in and him pounding and shit.
No. He wasn't having sex. He was just like hanging out.
Oh, jeez.
Like, I kind of, I think there was a lot of people, like a movie set. Like, I think they were filming a movie. And it was just like too much. I was just like, oh, this is creepy.
Why Brendan Fraser and not like Ryan Gosling or something?
I don't know.
Why is someone like.
I haven't thought of Brendan Fraser in years.
Yeah, who has thought of him in years?
He just showed up in my dream naked.
Dougley Do-Right, you saw naked.
Yeah, I saw his
I think
Dudley
you answered
dong.
Your own question. He had the longest dong, and
yeah,
that's why
I guess.
He was in the movie.
I wonder if he does in real life, and I just, like, predicted it in my mind.
Probably what if he doesn't? And you were just—he was trying.
I was just hoping for that.
Well, maybe he was sending like dream stuff.
Signals. Yeah. To me. This is like Inception.
Yeah,
like he's like he's got me like he's so like the way Inception works is that you have to like be beside the person and like hook into their dream. Yeah. So he's like in my bedroom, like sitting beside me, like hooking in my dream. Look at me naked, John.
And he does this.
You know what's funny about Inception? Every night. Like, yeah. Now that we talk about this,
oh yeah.
None of the dreams are dreams.
Mm-mm.
I wouldn't have a dream of any of that bullshit happening.
One thing
dreams are embarrassing.
Yeah.
Dreams are funny to others, but not to you at that moment, usually.
Yeah.
And dreams are everything but what that Inception
I've never had, like,
doing.
A realistic action dream.
Yeah, like, all those dreams were kind of, like, cool landscapey dreams. I have, like, either scary dreams or, like, a sexual dream. I don't really have...
I think the weirdest thing... I think one thing that movie did do really well, though, is that there's points where, like, a character will, like, turn and then it'll be a different scene. And that happens in dreams so much. Where you'll be doing one thing and then, like, you'll turn and then it'll be, like, a completely different dream.
Yeah, it's, like, fragmented.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
You want a movie that does dreams right? Akira Kurosawa's Dreams.
Oh, that movie's amazing.
What? His dreams and he made short vignettes about of them.
They're amazing.
And they are great.
What is it called?
Dreams.
Dreams. It's Akira Kurosawa directed Seven Samurai.
But it's like,
it's
his dreams.
That's a good movie.
It's his dreams, though.
Yeah. It's kind of neat to think about. Like, you watch it and it's beautiful, like, color.
That is
and...
a movie that is exactly what dreams are like, though.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Just weird and creepy. And...
Oh, I know.
It's just weird. Yeah, that's a great movie. Man, I didn't even think about that for a while. I want to see it again now.
There's a movie coming out pretty soon,
visually,
I think.
It's incredible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's in color. One of his few movies in color.
Martin Scorsese's in that. He plays Vincent Van Gogh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Anyway.
Well, there's a movie coming out pretty soon that's called ABCs of Death, where 26 different directors all around the world got together and, like... did different versions of death. It's kind of like a horror movie, but it's not. It's all like different movies rolled into one.
What?
Yeah.
That's weird.
Look this shit up when you get a chance. ABCs of death. It looks really gory, but it could be good. I mean, horror movies
really
typically.
Gory, it's going to be good.
Well, depends what you like. I don't really like gory. I would rather get scared shitless.
Suffer through Masters of Horror? Do we really need more of this?
Those are bad.
Those are really bad.
Oh, the Takashi, the Miike one is amazing and awful at the same time because they made everyone speak English and nobody speaks English and it sounds really bad.
Did you see John Carpenter's Pro-Life?
I did not.
No.
That's the one where Ron Perlman is gunning down an abortion clinic.
Huh.
Oh, and all his hillbilly friends are going to kill the abortionists.
Yeah.
And then at the end, he has a monster in him and he gets aborted or something. Like, the guy's, like, pulling it out of Ron Perlman. He's like,
butt? What? What? What is this? His butt and not, like, the tip of his dick or something.
That would be worse, I suppose.
That would
I don't
be
know what
terrible.
The fuck was going on.
Oh, God. Ron Perlman has a crazy fucking story of how he became who he is, too.
How's that?
He was on the Nerdist podcast a little bit ago.
You're just always dropping podcasts.
The guy... When they were doing Quest for Fire, that looked most like a monkey. they cast
true.
Him. That's like his first role, though.
Well, basically, what happened with him, he just did like shitty theater on Broadway. Like, not even on, like
off Broadway.
Yeah, yeah. And then some guy was like, "Oh, you look like a man. You're like a real man.
You look like a manly man."
Yeah, and that's why he didn't know how to fucking do anything. Like, he had no talent whatsoever when he first started. And then he just slowly.
I'm kidding. I love Ron Perlman.
And he doesn't believe that you should ever act other than. Yourself, just be yourself, and that's you'll be fine.
I mean, that makes sense.
That's a perspective, and for him, it's worked. Right?
It depends on what type of actor you are.
When he's in movies, I look forward to seeing him in movies.
I like seeing Ron Perlman in movies, except for
actors though where you play the same character of yourself.
Yeah,
and it's good if you're good. If you're a good
Tom Cruise has stopped playing other characters and basically was just being himself in films.
He was
now.
Pretty much always himself.
Yeah, he was all. Well, there was a few
was
of them
that,
that
far
were
far and away.
Tropic Thunder.
What
to
was
mind?
That 4th of July movie where he
Born
was
on the 4th of July?
Born on the 4th of July. Yeah, it was
that movie's
of,
awesome.
That's still, though,
the movie is depressing.
But that was
as
him.
Fun.
Still him, though.
That's true. Yeah. It was him. I don't actually.
Which is him as a veteran.
No, it was Collateral. He was him, but just with white hair. Yeah, no, you're right, Lantz. He's basically
it was evil
been.
Him.
And then you have like a Gary Oldman who does different things.
Yeah, Gary
midget.
Oldman, Dustin Hoffman plays people.
Tiptoes. Anyway.
Plays Sid Vicious.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She's Sid
Will
Nancy.
Smith is another guy who plays himself
Did
every
time.
You
see that Courtney Love was up for the role of Nancy in that? and they had the footage of her in their rehearsal tape.
Oh.
And she's like, this is the like 87 or something.
Yeah, yeah.
And she's like, the real reason I should be Nancy is because I am Nancy. And she's just like,
insanity.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, no.
She's being a strung out.
Yeah, no
chick.
Good. No.
Which
good.
She's probably right. She kind of is, you know, but.
Pretty much. That's not a good thing, though.
Wow. But in 1986, that was before she was really strung out, though, right? Like, she wasn't badass crazy by then, yeah.
I think she was just in the beginner stages at that point. Before she had gone full
on. She already
whack
burned
job.
Through all those Nirvana royalties.
Oh, probably.
Is she waiting desperately for another hidden semi-hit song to come
did
out?
Did you guys see
Paul McCartney stealing his thunder?
Did you see 12, 12, 12?
I did not. I really kind of want to see it.
I did not either. I heard a lot about it on Facebook.
I heard
McCartney on.
Well, I heard that Kanye West wore a like leather kilt for some reason.
Why?
Because he's Kanye West.
Because
he
wears
crazy
do,
clothing.
Yeah, he thinks he's a second coming of Jesus. So
and he
why
pretty
not?
Much is, but okay. I love Kanye. But anyway, he's a douchebag.
Kanye's
though.
Not even in the. He's on the downside, isn't he?
Oh, no.
No?
He's still releasing.
Prominent?
Oh, yeah.
I always thought he was kind of slowly
coming down.
He
hasn't released
an
album in 2 years, but, I mean, like, he still produces a lot
well,
of shit.
Well, 2 years isn't that bad.
No.
There's some guys who are still pretty big who haven't released an album in, like, 5 years.
Yeah. But anyway, yeah, so. Apparently Paul McCartney played with the remaining members of Nirvana. They had a new song that they had made together, and apparently it was pretty good. Huh. Like, McCartney was rocking out on the electric guitar quite a bit.
Why'd they get him, though?
Just because.
I think he offered.
I think.
I heard
well,
he
no,
offered.
I, yeah, they just met someplace and jammed, and they were like, oh, let's do a song. And they did. Mm. And it's for good cause.
And he was already there so, anyways. I
yeah.
mean, he was going to perform.
Yeah, he did a bunch of performances there, and then they just brought out the Nirvana people.
The
and
Who
like,
played too, right?
A lot of people played. It was a lot. It was a star.
Yeah, it was supposed to be the
I
biggest
heard the,
concert
I heard
of all time.
Some of it on the radio. And this is hilarious, because this is how like every Springsteen concert is.
Yeah, yeah.
I turn it on, and he's like, you know, we're really trying to help out that New Jersey boardwalk area because that's where we grew up, man. And that's where it was a really unique place where you could have firefighters and policemen. They could live on the boardwalk, man. It was like, this is...
All right, here's Born to Run.
Yeah. No, he goes into a song I've never heard before.
Oh, okay.
That
album,
also
sure.
sounds a lot like him.
And I've heard all the Bruce Springsteen albums, and I didn't know
he
was
one. He's one of those guys who doesn't like playing his oldies, right? Like, he doesn't like playing the classics.
He did for the Super Bowl.
He fucks with them, though. Good. He is. He likes to do different versions of Born in the USA instead of the one everybody wants to hear.
Yeah,
which is the pumped up rock
which I
version.
Understand. Like I you know, I get why he wants to like do something new with it and shit, but you got to understand that his old shit speaks to people and people really like that and we really appreciate to hear him do it live or whatnot. So
who's the other
dick,
guy?
You know?
Mellencamp's like that.
Yeah, he's
every
terrible
fucking
for that.
Time he does a live show. He changes every version of his hits.
Yeah.
You're almost like, what the hell? This is Jack and Diane without the signature rock guitar on it.
Yeah.
That's the guitar that made the song. Come on.
I guess. It's kind of one of those things, though, that, like, it's,
like
prob-
if you're,
it's probably cool if
you do a special show, do it that way.
Yeah.
But do, like, a whole tour? Come
it's,
on.
It's probably cool if you go to a lot of Mellencamp tours and you get to hear different versions every time.
Yeah, but who
but if it's your one time you go to see Mellencamp and he doesn't play the song the way that you remember it,
I don't think Mellencamp has groupies anymore. Like,
no,
I don't,
they're
I
all,
see...
like, 70-year-old women from
I mean,
New Jersey.
I think
Mellencamp's groupies are all farmhands.
I think that Aerosmith, weirdly enough, might have groupies again because of Steven Tyler being so
on American
famous.
Idol.
Yeah.
They don't have groupies anymore. When you reach that point...
I think he's off the show now.
They have named, yeah,
when
he's
you
off
reach
the show.
That
he left.
Point, you have the VIP
he wanted
the
tour
area.
Again.
Because the
they're
back.
Making money.
I thought he left because he didn't want to deal with their shit anymore.
Don't buy into that.
When
fucking
Aerosmith
made up
tours.
Hype.
Oh, really?
Well, apparently, like, they had all this controversy with, like, Mariah Carey and...
Oh, I didn't hear that. I just heard he didn't want to be
Nicki
on
Nicki Minaj
it.
Fighting, and it's like, this is all made up.
But you know, when Aerosmith tours, it's not like the old
makes
days.
Makes
me
not want to watch it.
They all have their own tour bus.
Yeah.
And they all... It's all very VIP, you know.
Yeah.
It's like their family's with them and stuff. So.
Well, like, American
I think groupies apply when you're, like, 50. I think, like, there's, like, what's that
do
band?
Do groupies exist as much as they used to? I don't even know. I don't
I
go
bet
to
the
concerts.
Younger bands, yeah. Like,
I don't even know that many.
But like, what's the deal with American Idol? So like, they used to have Simon Cowell, Randy Jackson, and what was her name?
Paula Abdul,
the cat song.
She wasn't the original though.
No, she was. Yes, she was. Yes, she was. That was the original three. And it was kind of like
Seacrest and the other guy. Yeah. Do you remember that?
Paula Abdul is so out of her mind.
Anyway, but you think about it. So you have Randy Jackson, who's like an accomplished musician, has done a lot of stuff.
Producer too.
And you have Simon Cowell,
which made sense for
who's
like
a music executive producer guy who finds talent and shit. Yep. So like it's his job. Yep. And you had Paula Abdul just for the girl
one
color.
Hit wonder
yeah,
kind of
the
person.
Color commentary.
A great choreographer.
And she's, yeah. you know, she has some insight. But like now it's like, I don't even know who's on it. It's like Nicki Minaj, Mariah Carey.
Who's Nicki
and
Minaj?
She's a rapper who came into prominence like 2 years ago.
Why is she on it?
I don't know. That's what I'm saying. Like the show had some legitimacy where it was like, oh, these are actual like music talent scouts talking to you. Now it's like, here's a couple washed up famous musicians commenting. And
before,
it's like, well.
Before they were all basically past their
prime.
Was
she in a band called Ménage à Trois?
No, but that would have been great. No, I don't think she can sing well. I think she's just a fairly well.
Oh, Keith Urban, apparently, as well.
Oh, well, yeah, you know. Well, that makes some sense to me. Hmm. But Nicki Minaj,
gives a shit
not at all.
He has to say about anything.
I actually really like Keith Urban.
I don't know Keith Urban at all. So,
let me guess what he
said. Oh no,
it's
Carl Urban was Judge Dredd. I get those two confused.
The sentence. No,
Nicki Minaj.
I am the judge.
Well,
says Carl Urban.
Britney Spears is on the X Factor.
Oh, that's what I'm thinking
right?
of. Yeah, too. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, there used to be people that were on there that literally were out of the business. Well, as a singer or musician for like 10, 15 years, you know. But now they're finding people that are just
Let's
recently
be honest.
Out of the out of
Randy
the business.
Jackson was a touring bassist for Foreigner in the 80s. It's not like he was a god of music.
Yeah, I agree.
But he
agreed.
Did a lot of music production. Right? Yeah. Like,
but
he's
now,
a producer.
But now they're bringing on people like Nicki Minaj, who's sold more records than anyone ever will, who wins American Idol.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The first three people who ever won American Idol, people know anything of.
Yeah, Kelly Clarkson, that's all I know.
Oh.
She's the one that won the
Carrie
first one.
Underwood.
And, Ruben stuttered, but he isn't in it. But Clay Aiken's still around.
Yeah, Clay
let's
Aiken.
Let's be honest,
didn't Clay, no, Clay didn't win?
Ruben no, he
didn't.
Lost.
What happened to Ruben?
He shouldn't have won.
Chris Daughtry didn't win either, but he's bigger than most of them.
Yeah,
most.
It's just
it's
how it
time,
goes.
Though, to stop Christ. Acting outraged about it, because we all know what it is. It's a big dog and pony show where basically it's for the purposes of that show.
Yeah.
There's drama and whatever is going on with the songs. But, yeah, no one's going to make it. I mean,
I think
no
it's had an air of legitimacy in the past, and now it's just out of the window
but as
now.
Soon as it
started, I just think it's, like, crazy.
As soon as it had to, like, scrap at ratings, then it got desperate and they had to do more crazy shit. You remember,
well, they have, like, 4 or 5 episodes worth of the terrible auditions
now. Yeah, I was
now.
Just going to say that. They
it's like...
It used to be just a part
one or
of
two,
an episode,
like the
now.
First 2 episodes, you know, or that, and then now, but now it's like seriously like 4 episodes, like 2 weeks of 2 episodes apiece of just the terrible auditions, and like the show isn't funny without Simon Cowell being a huge dick to everyone. Yeah. Like, who's the dick? I want to watch a British guy belittling people, and that's
I
why
I
watched
hear
it.
Fucking Keith Urban be like. Well,
that ain't country.
I can hear what you're doing, and you sang it from the heart.
Like Hank Hill,
apparently. He's Australian, so he's kind of cool. But anyways.
Yeah, they finish a track, and he's like, oh!
Well, hey, you guys might not remember this, but Ryan Seacrest had a co-host originally in the first
really?
Season. Yeah, do you remember him?
No, I don't.
As far as I understand, I've heard a lot
of rumors.
He
went by the handle Mario Lopez.
No, but he
the perennial co-host.
He was the Costello to Ryan Seacrest's Abbott, basically, you know? But I heard that Ryan Seacrest got him in trouble or something, and he was asked to leave. Before the beginning of the second season. So Ryan Seacrest became like the one host for the soon-to-be iconic American Idol. And all of a sudden, what happened to his career? It took the fuck off.
Yeah.
So that's kind of sketchy. I mean, the whole show is kind of weird.
Yeah.
A lot of the... I mean...
I'm over it.
Yeah, so am
I think I see those agree. Clips of... I saw a Norwegian one or something... Did you see the black metal guy on one of those?
Oh, no. I'm sure it was amazing.
It was. He was, like, screeching with the screechy metal vocals.
Yeah.
And he had the corpse paint on
and
stuff. And people were cheering and stuff, but obviously he would not be asked to return.
What's the show that Stern's on? Is that America's Got Talent?
America's Got Talent.
So it's Stern the Osborne, Sharon Osborne.
She's
and then
gone, though.
But I saw part of that episode. It was the final, and it was like this fucking weird acting troupe and like a fucking like light painting breakdancing thing.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
And it's like,
I auditioned for America's Got Talent a year ago.
What talent is this? Like, this is street performance.
Yeah.
You're not going to do anything with this.
Let's be honest. What that show should have been was Howard Stern and Artie Lang. And
oh, my
Robin
God.
Quivers judging the talent. I would have watched that.
That would have been good. They would have gotten, like, the last three episodes and be like, all right, now we got some real talent here, finally.
You know what they should have done? They should have had Joe Buck and Artie Lang do a show.
Oh, yeah, Joe Buck.
No, they lost
the
me.
The rapport of those two in that episode of his show on HBO was incredible. Like, the back and forth taunts and the ripping.
It was a bit. I think it went a bit far. Yeah.
That's why. That was why
it was
magical.
Awkward.
It's magical.
No, the show lost me once they had a guy named Prince Poppycock on there who was a drag professional. Not a drag queen, but a guy who was, like, ambiguously a girl.
Yeah.
And he was sing opera songs. He did a couple good ones. Oh, sorry, John. He did a
Jesus Christ.
I knocked your laptop. Let it happen.
Watch your hands.
Don't put it on
no,
an
no.
Angle. Well, you're gonna make me fuck shit up.
Well, so. Jesus
I'm
Christ.
I'm sorry, John. But anyways, his name is Prince Poppycock, and he wore really elaborate makeup.
Yeah. Why did they lose you? I thought you'd be way into
no,
that.
No, they lost me there because he didn't win when he obviously sort of won.
He was the best.
Yeah. He got beat out by a little girl singer, like a 12-year-old girl singing.
What do you win for that? I think it's talent contract.
No, you win a show in Las Vegas and $500,000.
Show in Vegas. Yeah, I'm like fucking Flamingo
one
Hotel.
One of the best guys. There was this these guys that made this suit.
Opening up for Don Rickles.
Yeah.
There was these guys 2 years ago that made like these suits that had like flashing lights, like LED lights.
Yeah.
And they could turn those lights off at any given time so they could program a whole show.
Yeah, yeah.
So you would have like arcade games in the dark going on with dancing. That was good shit.
Yeah.
But then there was guys.
How do you make an hour-long show in Vegas out of this?
Well, that you could. Okay. But a little 12-year-old girl singing? Why would I want to see that in
Las
Vegas?
Let's go see that. No.
Yeah.
No.
There was some cool Suker's Delay kind of shit going on. Hmm. But most of the time, it's a little girl singing or a guy playing a banjo. I mean, it's just stupid shit. Yeah.
It's
like the Gong
banjo
Show.
Never that good.
A guy playing the banjo should never win because he hasn't won in reality.
It's a banjo.
Yeah.
When's the last time a guy with a banjo won something? The Deliverance theme?
Well, I'll tell you a time when a lady playing a banjo won my heart.
Was she naked?
And that's Charlize Theron can play the banjo.
Can she really?
Yes.
Can she hold it with her, you know...
All-star celebrity
with her,
banjo session.
You know? Her vagina?
We'll get her
no.
and the other two people I know to play banjos, Steve Martin and Kevin Nealon, and they can form some kind of banjo trio.
Speaking of Steve
and don't
Martin,
forget the guy from The Office. What's his name with the actor's name?
John Krasinski?
No, the Andy Bernard character, and I can't think of that actor's
Ed Helms.
Name. Ed Helms can play the banjo as well.
Get him in there.
Yeah, let's get a banjo troupe together.
Speaking of Steve
that would be
Martin,
pretty kick-ass, actually.
Speaking of Steve Martin and the banjo, watched Three Amigos last night for the first time in like a decade. Fucking still good.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
After 20 fucking years, still fucking hilarious.
He's amazing in movies from the 80s.
Yeah,
like, he really knocked it out of the park.
Chevy Chase is a dick, by the way. I just want to throw that
out
there.
Oh, he is. He's a douchebag.
The fact that he left Community and the way he left Community.
Yeah, with like three episodes to film.
Yeah.
It's like, come
real.
On, dude.
Yeah,
I'm in his corner
because...
on this one.
What?
I think, He should.
Yeah, but you shouldn't.
Community
leave
was an
show.
Awful show.
It's an amazing show,
and you can't blame anyone
it's the best
for
show.
Wanting to leave before it was over.
It's an amazing show.
One
of my favorite shows on TV.
Yeah, I agree. One of the reasons my number five show that's on TV right now. The reason why he left was because
it's not on yet. They delayed it.
Yeah, they did
till February.
The reason why he left was because the dialogue and the plot were awful.
It's because his character is awful.
Yeah.
Because his character,
let's be honest,
he didn't want to be that character. Like we said in our previous episode,
the only
like,
reason they got this many episodes was because of Arrested Development. Because they thought this was the next Arrested Development of the critically loved show that nobody watched.
How can you not like the show?
How do you not?
You've
like
not
this
seen
show?
It.
I've seen like 10 episodes.
Ugh, something's wrong with your soul.
Yeah,
it's so. amazing.
I saw more than my share of it.
A guy who knows as much about movies as you do.
There's an episode where they do. Oh, never mind.
I don't like it because it's like an extended MacBook commercial.
What are you talking about? You have a really weird view of the show. Yeah. I thought that way too until I actually watched the show and I'm like, oh, it's a parody of a MacBook commercial.
I don't think you've seen this show.
But it's amazing because they do a whole episode where one of the characters does like a My Dinner with Andre, like line for line in a fucking, but like with his own weird way. It's crazy. That's why the show isn't doing anything because there's crazy movie references like that
but
nobody would get.
I thought a guy like you who knows every movie reference ever would actually like that show a lot because it starts off slow, it starts off season two
I'm watching chronological order, let's be clear on that.
Anyway, I'm sure like all things that you hate, you'll get into it like 5 years from now and we'll be like, yeah, we told you so.
Yeah, and you're one, just like Matthew, you're one of the people that helped it not be on air anymore. Because Matthew doesn't watch it either. He's waiting for it to be done.
So watch it.
Yeah.
He's a poor show.
Anyway. Well, it's had enough of a run. It's been on like for a long time, so.
It's on its fourth season.
Whatever. Yeah. The show's him attending college. 4 years, he's done.
At a community college, he's there for 4 years.
Well, you know.
Yeah. Good. Anyways.
So that's TV Talk 2012. Well, let's take a break, and then we'll come back with Christmas time.
Ooh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Alvin! Gear. We've been good, but me and last. Hurry Christmas, hurry fast. One complaint that loops a loop.
Take my shirt off?
No, you may not take your shirt off.
God damn it.
All right, and we're back from the break. Tyler's shirt is still on, so we're all safe.
I'm taking my shirt off.
All right, so Christmas is nigh. We are just 1 week away from Christmas Eve.
Oh, I'm so excited.
I know. I'm excited to get some gifts under the tree, relax by the fire.
What is the greatest Christmas present you ever got, John?
Greatest Christmas? And Nintendo 64.
A PS1.
Technodrome.
Wow. Oh, the Technodrome. You were the envy of all the children.
Yeah, you were.
Right.
Dude, that thing was kick-ass.
If it came open, you put the stickers on the monitors for the computer monitors.
Yeah.
Came with a bunch of stuff. Setting it up was the best part.
I had a Turtles, like, pizza shooting tank that shot little plastic pizzas. Oh. It would totally be illegal now because it shot plastic high velocity. Like, I would shoot it at my brother.
Yeah, like little missiles on the top, too.
You could flick, but it had, like, a like electric thing. It would go... Yeah. You put in the little plastic pizza discs, and it would go... Boom.
I remember those.
You could nail someone with that. My cousin had one of those. Yeah.
When I was 9 for Christmas, I got the full, like, the trilogy of Star Wars.
Yeah, on VHS.
Yeah. Whoa. Oh, that was amazing. Yeah. I remember staying up all night watching all three of them.
Of course.
It was like, oh, this is the best thing ever.
Great
gift.
That's
a pretty good gift, yeah.
All right. Well, I've got a gift for you two. So, in the vein of Lance's top 10 worst covers, metal covers of all time,
ooh,
we got a Christmas-themed one. Lauren and I devised the top 10 worst Christmas songs. Now, this... by no means is a composite list because there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of Christmas songs and they're all terrible. But I tried to pick quite a few from quite a few different genres.
Much like I did.
They're all terrible in their own ways.
So these are covers of
Christmas.
Oh.
These are all mostly originals.
Oh, because really?
I didn't want to come up with a lot of covers.
Okay.
Because who are we to say that's a bad version of Run, Rudolph, Run?
Exactly.
I don't like a good version of it. So.
Okay, good.
A lot of originals, some covers.
Okay.
It'll be in it. So we're going to go with the same format. You guys try and guess who this is. I'm going to tell you this first one. You're not going to guess who it is because I don't even know who it is.
Okay, let's establish this early on. What are the rules for this? Because I want to beat Lantz. And I want to do it good.
If you can guess the artist more or the name of the song. Just the artist.
Just the artist?
Because a lot of these Christmas songs you're going to be able to come up with the names with.
These are famous people, though, yes?
Not in this first one, but we'll get... I want you to listen to this because it exists.
2 points.
Edward Norton.
No.
How about this? 2 points for the artist, 1 point for guessing the title. Huh?
No.
Nothing?
I don't want to do the guessing the title.
Ah, darn it.
I just the artist. Okay, you're not going to be able to guess the first one. I'm telling you, the first one's unguessable.
All right.
All right.
Because I don't... It's a magical. All right, here we go. Oh.
Number 10.
Number 10 number on 10. The list. I got to get the audio back on.
Oh. Let me see. We have a scarf for Skywalker, right? Yes. And perfume for the princess? Yes. Yes. What about Han Solo? Couldn't we get him here? That leaves one big problem. The wacky. Couldn't we get him a comb? We gave him a comb. This is something stupid that, like, Moby would do. Why can't you get in a hurry for a furry kind of friend like that? Take home.
That little ditty. What do you get a Wookiee for Christmas when he already owns a comb?
Is it by, what the fuck is his name? Weird Al?
No.
Not
this
Weird
is
Al.
Nobody you would know.
Really?
This is off of the Star Wars Christmas album that came out in the late 70s.
Can I hear a little bit more?
Oh, yeah. Sure. It's we're only a minute into this 4-minute epic. We'll hear a little more.
The music, though, I don't like the
lyrics. It's a little bit like musical-y. Like,
yeah.
I could see this on stage.
Yeah.
No, I just like the music. I don't like any of the voices.
Yeah, I don't like the voices, but I like the beat and the melody of it. Yeah.
Sounds like a Mario Kart theme.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you're right. It is a little video game.
I can't listen to any more. We're going to end that one right now.
Yeah, I was just about to tell you to
stop. Okay. So that's number 10. I mean, it's weird.
Not offensively bad.
Just weird. Why does the Star Wars Christmas... Apparently impossible to find this album. I think it's vinyl only.
The Christmas special's hard to find.
Yeah.
This is even
This is
harder.
A musical album. Yeah, that was also released. Anyway. we'll
By
start
the way,
with
now that Disney owns the rights... They'll probably have the B. Arthur Christmas special on a special feature.
Hell yeah, they will.
In high def.
Oh, of course. I can't wait.
I don't need that in high def. I don't need that in high def.
They'll put it on the Disney Channel.
It's too bad, George Lucas. Anything that you put on TV will forever be kept, even though you want to destroy it.
I hope so. Yeah, he gave over all those rights for $4.7 billion. And hey?
It's what I said. Get ready for a special edition of Howard the Duck DVD.
He did something awesome, is he donated all of that money to charity, which is amazing.
Whoa.
How much did you
say?
4. What?
7 billion. 4.7
billion.
So once
they put the Howard the Duck movie out,
yep.
They'll be in the hole for 4.78.
Yeah, yeah. No, he donated all the charity. Well, he already had 23 billion to begin with.
He didn't have 23 billion.
No,
he had
he
2.3.
He,
Bill Gates only has 6 billion.
No, Bill Gates has 60 billion.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Microsoft guy.
He's up there. I don't know if it was 23, but it's in the team. I mean, it's more than one like 10 billion. It's like crazy.
Fuck.
It's crazy. Because he owned all the merchandising rights, and that's all Star Wars is.
Because movies never made merchandising before that.
Nope.
Anyway.
It's one, and it's an amazing story if you haven't read about it about how he got the rights. Because they were like, "Fuck, give him the rights. What? Who cares? T-shirts? They'll just buy T-shirts." And no, toys, everything started that whole craze. All right.
Oh wow.
This one you will be able to guess. The musician of, and I hope you enjoy. This is a very
raise your hand if you got a guess.
Yeah, raise your hand if you got a guess. Give it at least 30 seconds here. I don't want you to.
All right, let us know when it's been 30 seconds. Like,
okay.
Give us a signal.
You're not going to get it, so don't worry about it.
Oh, I will. Lantz.
The live version.
Oh, yeah. Country. I'll know it.
Oh yeah, rocking.
Good, I like it already.
Fiddle.
What the?
No, yep. Is that John Mellencamp?
30 seconds is up.
Is it John Mellencamp?
John Mellencamp.
Fuck
it
you!
Is.
Oh, yes!
Don't pull your headset out.
I'm
here.
Sorry.
You're too animated here.
I'm sorry.
That was right at 31 seconds. You raised your hand as well.
I didn't even know he did a Christmas song, but I knew that voice. Yeah.
This is intense. The YouTube video for this. It's just him and like a bunch of little girls on tambourines and like. Let's hear a little more.
Okay.
Sure.
That's John Cougar Mellencamp.
I just like his voice singing a Christmas song.
This is a really weird cover.
This is old school Mellencamp with the long flowing brown hair. Oh my god, I can't even hear the lyrics. He's just putting so much Mellencamp stank on it. That's what I call it. Ooh, yeah. Violin solo.
Is this original then, yeah?
Well, the song? No, it's not him. I mean, it's a song that's been around, but.
What is this?
I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus.
Oh, I couldn't even recognize it.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, really? Maybe because I have a speech impediment, I can understand him better.
Okay, we've had enough. So that's number 9. I thought it was really terrible that he did.
It's pretty bad.
It's honestly one of the worst Christmas songs, I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus, and he did a version of it.
I liked that.
Oh, well.
I liked it.
You're the only one.
You and the 12 girls on stage enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, we're friends. You know, Isabelle's a really good girl.
Actually, probably about your age, too. From the look of it.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
It was probably in the late 80s.
I mean, you're going to have fun. They give you a tambourine.
Wait, ain't I 31, though?
Oh, yeah. You're 31. Sorry.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Creepy shit going on here.
They're your girlfriend's age.
In the studio apartment.
Number 8.
Sounds kind of like the chicken song. What the hell is this? It's not a cover. Oh my god, this.
No. Fuck!
Lantz gets the first shot.
Shit.
Cyndi Lauper?
Yes.
God!
Lantz is at 2 points.
Oh shit, you're quick, Lantz.
Cyndi Lauper with her weird island rhythm rocking around the Christmas tree version. It's really bad.
Oh, I'm in a hole.
You were in the hole, dude.
Ah, 2-0. Shit, early on.
Were you going to guess Cyndi Lauper?
The only one I had no idea. She has that.
Well, you know, it's
voice.
Because she doesn't like to make a note last longer than half a second.
Yeah.
Yes, it's bad. Yeah, I was looking for, you know, songs. I know Rocking Around a Christmas Tree, and I was like, what's the worst version? And I found this.
Okay.
And,
the opening doesn't sound anything like it.
No.
I was like, there's no way this is a cover.
Nope. It's a cover. Yep.
It's pretty disgraceful.
Yeah, we don't need to listen to any more of that. But I do have a secret bonus extra song.
Oh.
7.5. Another version of Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree.
Are we guessing
this The Cyndi Lauper one was worst, so I had to put that one on the list. But this one's really bad, too. Yes, this is a guessable one.
Bonus points for this one?
No, same amount of points.
Damn it.
Ready? Here we go. I'll give Tyler the first shot on this one.
Ashley Simpson?
No.
Madonna?
No.
Oh.
We'll continue.
Oh.
Tyler?
Avril Lavigne?
No.
Shit.
Think a lot newer than that.
A lot newer?
Yes.
Oh,
then 2008.
All right, we only got 3 guesses each, right? We can't be going
on.
Are you
just making that up?
I'm just saying.
I'm going to give you each one more guess.
Okay.
And we'll listen to a little bit more.
Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
We'll give you the first guess.
Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. Oh yeah, you will get a
This is just awful.
God.
But the Lauper one's worse.
It's terrible. It's just worse.
7.5. All right, Tyler, your final guess.
Katy Perry?
No.
Oh, my God. Who is it?
I'm thinking,
I'll give you a little more time if you want it.
A little bit more.
All right. Give it to you, 2008. Think country, but not really country.
I was just thinking country.
Not country, though.
Come on, help. Hey, Mom, just help me out.
You shot all your guesses off right away.
Yeah, I did. Because it sounds a lot like a young girl.
It's maybe too loud. Oh, I blew everyone's ears out.
Oh, wait, this can't.
All right, Lantz, you want your guess here? I'll allow Tyler to steal, because I'll just be giving a Christmas gift.
Gosh.
If you don't.
I think in country or whatever, or country rock, but I really just don't have a guess. I don't have any idea.
Okay, if this is who I think it is, this is terrible. Taylor Swift?
No.
Okay, who is it then?
Miley Cyrus.
Oh. What? No, she's not really a singer. That doesn't count.
Yeah, I had to put that
she
one in.
That would have been that would have been a good guess.
Yeah.
Pain of a tan in my ass.
But I don't really know what she sounds like.
Yeah, I don't know. I never listened to her shit. I don't know. Wow, I threw out a fucking ton of that. I was really
you
sure.
You were close with Taylor Swift. That's basically the same thing.
No, Taylor Swift is actually legit to some extent. Like, I don't even
Let's
think...
Let's not get into big Taylor Swift versus
I love Taylor Swift. I really fucking love that girl.
Really?
As a songwriter,
I'll
she's
give her,
amazing.
I will give her props because, A, she apparently made $17 million this year, which is amazing for a musician to do.
Yeah,
and B, she writes all her own shit. So at least she has some integrity.
I don't like her songs that much, but I like the fact she writes her own song and they're good lyrics.
Well, she tries, at least. She's not like some Britney Spears who's writing
I don't feel like
her.
I should have to give credit to artists for writing their own songs.
Though. I do. As an artist, Lance.
And you know what? You know what? I'm not going to. I'm not going to give them credit.
I will.
For a pop star, she gets a shot, I guess.
She's a great lyricist.
All right. I guess I'll give you points for the name of this song. I won't. You just need to tell me what this is. It's not... You'll hear. Okay. This is a classic.
This is number six now.
No, this is number seven. That was 7.5. I had to throw it in there because I hated that version almost as much as the Cyndi Lauper one.
It's pretty terrible. And the fact that Molly did it.
Miley. But yeah.
Same thing. Yeah. Miley, Hannah Montana.
Now she's just smoking weed and whatever.
Billy Ray Cyrus' kid.
All right.
Yeah. Achy, breaky heart.
Okay, think 80s. Yeah, you'll be able to hear it 80s, I guess.
Is Miley Ray Cyrus basically what happened after his achy breaky heart?
They call her Miley Ray Cyrus the virus. She's killed more people than cancer. It's Christmas
time. Whoa. There's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time,
we let it light and we banish it. This is worth 2 points because this is.
Give us a guess.
It's not one artist, but various artists.
Oh, is it a band?
Oh, no. Multi-artist collaboration.
This is the same guys who did this stuff with Michael Jackson.
Is this Hall or someone from Oates in the Hall?
It is very 80s. I will say this was done to raise money for children in Africa.
Of course.
Oh, so this is the Michael Jackson thing, right? They did the same thing to me.
This is not Michael Jackson. This is something entirely more British. I'll give Tyler the first guess.
Is this Bono?
Actually, it is, yes.
So
you need to name what this is.
It's Christmas time? I don't know.
So no. What do we need to name? What do we need
What the event was called.
Oh,
what
fuck.
It is known as.
I mean, one of the voices
Christmas
sounds...
Christmas Aid?
No. Close. Tyler, I'll give you a guess. This is worth extra points because it's kind of tricky. If you know the song, you'll know it immediately, but...
The Christmas Time Benefit?
No, God. Jesus, not even trying.
What? I was trying.
Let's get a little more sting. I'll name out the artists.
Is it music or something?
Not like
Boy George there. Live Aid's very close.
I said Life Aid.
It's very close to Life Aid.
No, there's an aid in there.
There's an aid in there.
I said Christmas Aid.
Song is
Life
Do
Aid.
They Know It's Christmas? Because they're in Africa.
Because they're in Africa.
Do they know it's Christmas?
Oh, Jesus.
That's amazing.
All right.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I'm going to give you
that. That song would not happen today, by the way.
That's
you
amazing.
Cannot get away with
I
that
mean, we've
song.
We've got Bono, we got George Michael, Boy George, and Sting here.
I feel like I should get... If Tyler wasn't getting so thoroughly dominated by me... Maybe I deserve a point.
You did
for
get
the
Bono
promo.
Exactly when he was singing.
That's pretty impressive.
But I won't take the point since you've been so mid.
Well, hold on.
This is a classic.
No. It's like you
okay.
can hear that. You
I don't
beat.
Want Lantz to pity me. So take the fucking point.
Oh, okay.
I don't
take
know.
Take the point.
If I'm not giving Lantz a point.
If I take the point, there's no coming back from it. You'll never catch up to
I
me.
Will, Lantz. I'm going to come back from the grave and slowly beat you with my dead body. I like that.
These other singers. What do you name the couple?
I have no clue who this is.
About, like...
I would like to mention that the Earwolf Studios did an amazing cover version of this with a bunch of comedians just, like, throwing on all their special sauce. I'll put a link to it in the... actually, maybe I'll play it. I'll play it in the break music. So.
How about Holiday Aid?
No, close. It's Band Aid.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
I think I've heard of that.
Yeah exactly.
Aid, that's terrible.
Yeah, you know, so.
Holiday Aid.
80s. The 80s.
You were close. Holiday Aid.
I said Christmas Aid.
Mm-hmm.
Band Aid. I wouldn't think Band Aid would be a Christmas one, though.
Yeah, that's just what they named themselves for that. All right. So we got the scores at Lantz at 2 and Tyler at 0.
Lantz at 3, Tyler at 0.
Nope. Lantz is at 2.
Yep. Lantz is at 3. That's what I heard.
You just are digging yourself into a deeper hole.
All I right. did not recognize Sting, though. I didn't know Sting was in
yep.
that.
Sting was there. He's kind of in the background a little
really
bit.
I really thought David Bowie was in there. Like, I really,
no.
really
which
I did
for
not
Sting,
hear a David Bowie.
Which for Sting is a bit
once
hard
heard,
for him to be in the background.
Once I heard Bono go his, like, it's Christmas time. And I was like, oh, it's Bono.
I just want to say this, by the way, just an FYI. Fuck YouTube ads. All I'm going to say
oh,
is.
Oh, I know, right?
They're getting worse.
Oh, and the worst part is that this is somebody who took a song, uploaded it, and it's not the owner of the song, but they put ads on it to make money off of it.
Yeah.
Fuck you, you asshole.
Yeah.
All right, anyway, so I just had to skip the ad there so we could get into this one. Number 6. This is a tricky one and really terrible.
Okay. Can you give us a hint beforehand or you want to...
Oh, no. I'll think, I would say, think early 90s.
Oh, little train.
It's a little skit
elf,
at the start.
Great Christmas.
Ah, man, it's boring. It's boring. Same thing every year.
So let's have a funky Christmas.
So it's a rap.
Oh, God. Just wait. I got my hand up.
I'm going to give it 30 seconds, hey, but I'll let you get the first guess.
Maybe I'll wait.
It's not too live crew.
I'm just going to grab Master
Mike. This is pretty funky.
Funky.
Have a funky, funky Christmas.
This is a wonderful.
What is this song?
Have a funky, funky Christmas.
Yeah, we're dancing here.
Funky, funky Xmas. Name of the song.
Well, they just said it.
They just ruined it with their having to shout out their own band name.
That was New Kids on the Block.
That was New Kids on the Block.
Oh, Jesus.
With Funky
New Kids
Funky
on the Block.
This band was popular.
Oh,
I would like to mention
that
in the 90s, people listened to this bullshit.
Yeah. Oh.
This is really, honestly, it's like being stabbed in the face.
Yeah, it's terrible. Did they just repeat this over and over again?
Yeah, it's really bad.
It's just this one phrase.
Wow. It's barely even funky.
It's like the Seinfeld music with them saying it's a funky, funky
what,
Christmas
they sound
over
tone
it.
Deaf when they're like, have a,
it's
funky,
a funky, funky,
funky
Christmas.
Christmas.
Yeah. And why would you want your Christmas to be funky? Like, of all the things that a Christmas could be,
that's true.
Why would you want it to be funky? Maybe Mary, yes.
I was at least
wonderful,
expecting,
yes.
Before they said New Kids
even
on the Block,
sexy.
I was like, it's just some kind of late era, what's that guy's name?
Grandmaster Mix-a-Lot.
He's the guy who did the Superstition, or not Superstition, Rick James song from like 1992. I didn't know.
No, I agree. Like, I was totally going in the wrong direction.
Once you say funky, I expect them to be black.
I'm terrible, too. I'm happy you said it, because yeah. I was thinking it was definitely...
Then, it's New Kids on the Block, so obviously... Well, I mean, if you think, oh, it's trying to be black, so it's New Kids on the Block.
Oh, yeah.
Have a funky, funky Christmas. Hey, I think we could do it. Let's go on the road, the three of us.
All right.
We'll do a remix of that song.
All right, sounds good. Let's do it. Let's do it. 3, 2, 1. Have a funky, funky Christmas. Yeah. We pretty much did exactly what they did there. All right. So, score remains 2-0. Thank you, New Kids, for ruining that.
Yeah, no, right? Just name-dropping yourself on the song.
Yeah, way to shoot us in the foot. We probably wouldn't have got that, though. I was really not looking in that direction at all.
It's all right. It's all right. It's all right.
New Kids on the Block.
Born in the 80s in the block.
Yeah.
They're recording it. And they're like, oh, I like how you just threw in like New Kids on the Block.
Yeah,
like,
just so people know it's us.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they're never going to guess it. We're new. We're hip. It's a funky Christmas.
Yes.
This one smells nasty.
This is...
Well, they weren't even a funky band, though. That's
no,
what,
they were
that
straight up
that
pop.
Funky either.
They were straight up like, you know, kid pop. They weren't that... I mean, they were trying to be badass, and they really weren't.
I only
at
know
all.
That one song. It's like,
yeah.
Hang
yeah.
Tough?
Yeah.
Yeah, Hang Tough.
Yeah.
Yeah, and
not
they,
tough.
They
you're,
always,
come on. They're a bunch of
guy,
white kids.
That one guy always wore a bandana and, like, holes in his pants all the time to look like a street rat.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
He's from the streets. Yeah. The new block with the kids on it.
And all those guys grew up in suburbs.
Yeah.
All those guys did.
Okay. This next one, it's a single person, not a band. Give you that hint right now.
All right, good.
This one is truly awful. We're at, let me just check to
five
see where
now?
On the list we are. It is number 5.
Ooh,
on the list.
Top 5 coming up.
All right, I'll give 2 points for this one because
wow.
It's kind of out there.
Okay.
But I'm going to give it 1 because
you
might recognize the voice
you
know immediately.
2 with no hints.
All right, well,
no
I already
hints.
Gave you a hint.
Well, I didn't
person.
Hear it. I forgot
it's
about it.
Solo
already.
Artist.
It's a solo person.
That's not a hint.
Yeah,
that was the worst one so far.
Oh,
that was
it's
terrible.
It's silent.
Yeah,
no,
imaginary friend. That's what that was called.
Yeah.
I'm Shelley Duvall.
God damn it!
This is Shelley Duvall.
Yes.
Well, we kind of guessed that anyway.
I would have guessed it. There's no way I would have got it.
Listen to this motherfucking shit. This is what plays in hell.
The
you know, it's like I couldn't get enough of her voice. I need her talking at 100 miles an hour,
but this
saying
is,
the same thing over and over again.
Shelley Duvall's a chick from The Shining, right?
Yes, and
so,
Popeye.
This is what drove her husband mad in that movie.
I'm sure.
This is what happened.
He heard this. I'd like to mention the cover of this album, which will be the cover of the episode, is the best thing I've ever seen. It's Shelley Duvall with like 18 cartoon animals around her. And it says, "Hi, I'm Shelley Duvall. Merry Christmas."
She actually doesn't look god-awful in that
picture.
Well,
that's because she in the 80s, she probably got a lot of plastic surgery and
oh,
did a bunch of stuff, yeah.
Look, play a little more.
There's Shelley Duvall's little Bo Peep like cartoon special that was on ABC that's awful. Ooh. That I'll have to play some songs from. I believe Bobcat Goldthwait is in it. It's Alice in Wonderland. It's awful.
Blackberry, raspberry, cherry kind of Christmas. It's a very customary. It's absolutely rare.
This is like it should be from the Halloween before Christmas. The Nightmare Before Christmas.
It's Christmas, Christmas. What a nice little holiday this is.
She can't sing, first of all.
It's Christmas.
She's got one note.
The nicest time of the year.
Oh.
It's a very culinary celebration.
This is like what would come out of Disney's asshole. Yeah. Just shat out.
Yeah. This is the song that Walt Disney sang just before he died.
Yeah, no, this is what caused him to die. Oh, my God.
All right, number 4.
I'm sorry about that.
It's okay. We forgive you.
This one definitely won't throw out the name, but I think no one will guess this.
Did you pre-screen these beforehand?
Well, I did, but I wasn't thinking of doing
I'm almost expecting like an Alice Cooper song at this point.
Yeah, like I'm expecting something more.
I'll blow down you. Yeah. Candy House.
I really wish I would have found those, but those are trying to be stupid, you know what
You're
I mean?
Right.
I was trying to find ones that are actually stupid.
They take themselves seriously.
Okay, this is one that gets played a lot, and it's I hate
I could have heard
this.
The last one in the horror movie, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
That would have been a good... Maybe in the Chucky movies when they're at the toy store, that song's in the background just to put you on edge.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we're in for a ride.
Oh. Is that an allusion to the song?
This is a classic Christmas song. It's a crazy poll if you can get this name.
Early 90s.
I've got one. I'm just going to throw one out here.
Okay.
Right, go for it.
LaToya Jackson.
No.
I was thinking of the other Jackson.
I'm done. I got to guess anything else on this. I have no idea.
Well, just think
Let's
like
just
late.
Listen to more saccharine off.
Think of late 80s. I just love her giddy ups. Giddy up, giddy up.
Sounded like anyone I can remember.
Just think of late 80s, early 90s pop divas. This is like the most I want to stab myself version of this song.
All right. Give us one more hint, because honestly, me and Lantz are both looking at Charlie like this is...
I'm trying to focus on the song a little bit, and it's awfulness.
I will say, in 1988, she was announced or pronounced to be the youngest artist to write, produce, and perform a number one single on the Billboard Top 100.
It was not this song.
No.
Yes. Okay. The only one I could think of that was young at that time point was Janet Jackson was young.
This is not a black lady. You guys are just all up on the black ladies here. The Jacksons.
That was my first question.
No, she's black. God.
No, I thought
she, is
not.
She black?
I don't think she's
I don't know
black.
About Paula Abdul.
Is Paula Abdul black? I don't know. I thought she was like you know, some type of...
I'll give a hint. Maybe Lantz, this will ruin it.
Youngest?
I can't give you any of the songs because I might ruin it.
Who's big in the late 80s?
I know, Lantz. Like,
she's kind of had a movie resurgence lately. On the Sci-Fi Network.
I don't know.
Oh, you just...
Mega Shark versus Octopus. She's in that movie.
Oh, yeah, of course. Just gave it away, John.
Mega Shark versus...
She shared the 1989 ASCAP Songwriter of the Year Award with Bruce Springsteen.
Wow. She was really up there.
Yeah.
Let's hear some more, right?
Okay, just a little more. We're about more. Halfway through. This makes me want to go on a sleigh ride. Farmer Gray, a underappreciated Christmas character. There's a party at Farmer Gray's.
I have a guess.
Okay.
This is a weird one.
Okay.
Sheena Easton?
Oh, no. Oh. Sorry.
Oh, I got nothing, don't
All you? Right. Well, I'm just going to have to call this no contest. Debbie Gibson. Debbie Gibson, who was barely
popular. I was
popular.
On the right track, I think, with the
Easton. Yeah, Sheena Easton. I was giving you a little closer, but...
It was not there.
Not there, 100%.
Debbie Gibson, I forgot about her.
Yeah, exactly. Everyone did.
We're going...
Because she sounded like that. That's why.
So let me recap. Right now, Lantz is at 2. I'm at 0.
Yep. Yeah.
And we're going into the third run right now.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
This one's going to have an ad because it's a sponsored website, so we'll just wait for the
Debbie
ad to play
Gibson.
Here.
She sounds like that.
Yeah. She's actually still pretty hot. I'm not going to lie. I saw pictures.
Well, good for her.
Burning it up on the Sci-Fi channel.
I think it's the Sci-Fi Network does those Mega Shark commercials.
I mean, they did. And Mega Shark, I mean, everyone knows that show. You know?
Mega Shark versus Super Python or
yeah,
whatever the fuck it's
Super
called.
Super Python. I mean, that's some big, know, that's something some big like stuff. That. You know, when you are acting on the Sci-Fi channel, you know you're just one step away from...
She was a judge in 2003.
You're probably working there to, like, clean their floors.
Well,
if you're acting in their movies.
I shouldn't say that because
they're probably like, once you finish the scene, like, go clean the bathroom. There's shit everywhere.
Zooey Deschanel and Alan Cumming was in the Tin Man.
Yeah.
And they are both huge stars.
the one crossover show.
Yeah, the one
that they ever had made.
All the other ones were terrible. So you're right.
Okay. Now, listeners, and you too, I want to warn you, this may cause you to kill yourself.
I'm already borderline.
We're getting
right
to
now.
That point.
I can't handle it.
We're getting to that point. You're going to have to guess.
Instead of feeling the Christmas spirit, we're really feeling the Christmas dread of, like, that moment where you realize, like, maybe, yeah, like, you didn't want to spend this much on those gifts, and you're like,
yeah,
no.
While this is going on, think about your favorite Christmas song after this. Just because this is getting, I'm gonna hang myself after this episode.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, we'll try and get some positivity for the end here.
Is there such a thing as a favorite Christmas song?
Well, I have several. I love Christmas.
Okay. I like Christmas too, but I don't know if I have a favorite. I think I got a favorite song.
Moran and I listen to Pandora Christmas music all the time.
Oh, you guys are the worst. All right. Here we go. You may want to kill yourself. I remember liking this song when I was little, and I want to kill myself for that.
Real Big Fish.
Oh. That wasn't 30 seconds, Lantz. 1 point
Tyler
deducted.
Gets the first next guess.
1 point deducted.
Oh, fuck. Why'd I have to say? Yes.
Let's get through the verse here. Oh. If you don't know who this is, you're crazy.
Oh. I know who it is.
Oh, I'm so scared. There's so much pressure on me right now.
This is awful.
Okay.
Oi to the world.
Okay.
Oi to the world.
Is this
a punk band? Yes.
Is this Gwen Stefani?
Yes. You got yourself a point.
Oh, thank God.
Shouldn't give it to you because it's No Doubt.
I knew that.
But it's a Gwen Stefani.
I jumped the gun on the Real Big Fish.
I don't know why.
I heard those trumpets and I was like, this is Real Big Fish.
You forgot No Doubt existed.
I did.
Oh, and they made this horrendous version of Joy to the World.
If I had waited 10 more seconds, I would have had a point, but oh well.
Oh yeah.
Song mixes everything I hate about ska everything I hate about Christmas.
And they changed the lyrics.
Awful fucking experience.
I just want to say it's Oi to the Punks.
Yeah, that's the
Oi to the Skids.
Yeah.
Oi to the world.
The only reason I knew it because of Oi, because she always makes words
Oi.
Up. Like in
punk.
Like banana. Like what is that one song? You know, ain't no hollaback girl.
Yeah.
Shit's bananas. B-A, whatever the fucking shit.
Yeah.
She makes shit up in every song she does.
Yeah.
Well, that's a pretty...
What?
Deep cut, I think.
They are rocking this, and there's like an Indian theme going on in this video. It's pretty crazy. Oh my God, they're punking it so hard.
Oh, the layered Stefani. I can't take it. That is a worst so far.
She
is still
is
really
bad,
hot,
though.
I gotta give her credit. She's very attractive.
I don't know. The Shelley Duvall is up there in my list of horrible.
Her attractiveness? Oh.
No, I'm like terrible shit that we just heard.
Yeah, the Shelley Duvall one's real
bad. This is
bad,
but I don't know if I would say it is the worst.
It's a worst I've heard tonight.
Okay. All right, we'll see.
If I had to listen to 2 more minutes of that.
All right, Lantz. It's going to get real. We got 2 more left.
I don't even know. Honestly, I don't even know that I can give the last one points for because I think it will be who can raise their hand first fastest. But we've got one more before we get there.
We got to wait 30 seconds. We got to wait. That's a rule.
Well, I know, but it's whoever raises their hand first can guess, but we won't let you guess before 30 seconds are up.
You might as well just raise your hand right away then. That's what he just said.
Yeah, but I mean...
The strategy in this
game. Well, we want to hear the songs as well.
Well, the strategy is if you raise your hand
as we saw,
you don't know what it is when 30 seconds comes up, you lose your first guess.
I jumped the gun on the last one.
And that cost you.
It cost me because as soon as she started singing, it was No Doubt to me
and
not the Real
Big
Fish.
But you also said it before the 30. If you would have just waited.
Yeah.
You would have had it.
Yep.
But the right strategy is just to raise your hand right away.
2-1 with 2 left. It's anyone's game. Unless Lantz gets this one, which he might.
If he gets this one.
You both have an equal shot at getting this one. All right, here we go. This one's really bad and okay. short, so we may listen to the whole thing.
It's pretty good.
This is the 90s, right?
Oh my god.
It's breaking the audio.
I don't know for sure.
I got one. The only place you'll want to be
is underneath my Christmas tree. I don't think you're going to get it.
Lantz?
I don't
you
think.
You said 90s?
I did not say 90s. He said
90s. I said 90s. You got to give us, you got 3 seconds. One.
I rescind my guess. I'm sorry.
All right.
Continue.
Oh, okay.
Well, he didn't say a name, so he gets a chance.
I'm backing
off. I'm going to read the lyrics because you can barely hear them, and they're the worst thing I've ever read. The only place you want to be is underneath.
Put me on top. Let's this cannot be Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga.
Oh my god!
You got her.
Whoa, 2-2. We tied up, motherfucker.
Well, 3-2 if you count.
No.
Oh, okay. Now that it's close.
It's 2-2 now. I was gonna guess tag team.
No.
So the whoo! I heard that, I was like, it's tag team because it's from the
Light Me Up.
It takes
Put
two.
Me on top. Let's fa la 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 la. This is a Christmas song about someone being under her Christmas tree and banging. Okay. It's terrible.
I have to point something out, guys.
Yes.
So the two people that I just got, Gwen Stefani and Lady Gaga, are really big in gay nightclubs. That's how I got those. Yeah. Just to throw that out there.
Lance got Mellencamp and Cindy Lauper.
The next one's Madonna.
What's that say about you?
The old, old
if the next one's Madonna or Chris Daughtry, I won this.
You know, we'll do two more. We'll do two more.
Okay.
Because
tiebreaker.
Yeah, because this last one doesn't really count because it's
starting to sweat.
It's not. We're gonna play it because it's my choice, and we'll play Lauren's choice.
Okay. Oh, okay. I see how it is. All right, ready? You ready, Lance? I'm ready. You ready, bitch? Bring on.
There's no way I could get the last one, so it's fine.
I kind of want some more of this Lady Gaga song, to be honest with you.
I kind of liked it. I want to have sex to it. But I always want to have sex to Lady Gaga songs.
There's two of them? Everybody knows we will take off our clothes. Yes, if you want us to, we will you
Christmas. Oh, my Christmas tree is delicious, huh?
I want to see the outfit she wears when she sings
this song. The song is about eating out Lady Gaga. That's all I'm saying.
Why not? I would.
I would too. But because I'm sure she'd be wearing some crazy meat dress, and it'd be a story to tell.
And wearing dick shoes, dick high heels that she wears all the time.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
All right.
Okay, boys.
Want to talk some trash, Lance? Want to hype this up?
Yeah, we'll let this thing load because I'm sure it has
come on, Lance. Come on, you Doogie Howser wannabe fantasy novelist. Yeah, I just threw that shit down. Bitch.
Doogie Howser wannabe.
I vote Tyler stop trying to fill air.
Yeah.
No. Okay, come on.
Stop, we're ready.
Dr. Horrible, degree in horribleness.
Well,
another Doogie
Howser.
I'm
saying this one's worth 0 points.
I think Tyler should lose a point for what he just
Here we
said.
Go. Let's just go.
Chipmunks. Obviously, it's Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Yeah, Alvin.
That's why I couldn't give you any points. Okay,
Simon. This is someone said this is the worst?
Yeah. It's my. I fucking hate
this
song.
No, this is the worst. No.
Really? I hate this
song. The Gwen Stefani one is, like, not as bad as this?
Listen to this. This is what plays in my nightmares. The best part is that you can slow this down. And it sounds hellish.
What does it sound like? You gotta play it.
I have played it on a previous episode of a Christmas is Terrible episode last year. I would like to also say that they record it backwards and then put it forwards and pitch it forward. That's how they get the chipmunk voice. It's fucking crazy when you slow it down because it sounds like they're talking backwards. It's amazing. We don't need to listen anymore because you guys know what this is.
Yeah, and we've heard this on several. It's like one of the only ones on here I've heard, like, not just on this list, but like heard like on the radio.
Yeah, it's a terrible one. Yeah. It's the worst.
But it's not that terrible. Like
it's, I hate it. I hate it.
The Shelley Duvall one.
Oh God,
the Gwen Stefani one.
The Shelley Duvall one's offensive, and the Lady Gaga one.
The Duvall one, I feel like she's trying to do what they did.
Yeah,
the newest like, kids on the block was better than this song, John.
I just hate the Chipmunks. I hate them. I hate everything they stand for.
I think you're biased. I don't think you should have made this list. I think you're
biased.
Well,
that's why we're going with the real worst song, according to Lauren, my girlfriend.
Good.
She said I had to put this song in here.
All right.
So I did. All right, let's enjoy this.
It's for all the marbles, by the way. Two and two, me and Lantz.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby. I'm hurried down the chimney tonight.
Lantz, you have a guess?
Marilyn Monroe?
No, but it's someone doing a Marilyn Monroe impression.
Here we go.
Santa baby, an outer space convertible to
one arrow.
Blue.
You guys should get this without a hint. Come on.
This
is for all the marbles. I gotta give you guys all the shots.
Yeah.
But you're next.
I'm next. I'll give a shot in the dark here. You get it. My name's Shot.
Yeah.
Very good. I'll play a little more. Just give me a little more.
Fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year, I could be oh so good.
Okay, I'll give a guess. So, okay, a person who would do an impression of her, I don't know, Madonna?
Yes.
Yes! Fuck you, Lance!
Madonna.
Yeah!
Wow.
Santa Baby, doing her craziest voice possible.
Yeah!
You want to know what my guess was?
What?
Thank you, K-Bars!
Melanie Griffith.
Ugh.
That's what I thought it was, though.
It's someone doing a voice. It's kind of tough.
I can imagine who would do a Marilyn Monroe, and...
Ooh, I need a fucking belt. Wear a belt every time
So that was the top 12 songs of Christmas. Hey, actually, that kind of worked out.
Yeah,
actually did. Yeah, 12 worst songs of 12 Days of Christmas.
Oh, well, Lance...
I like the fact that Tyler...
Came from behind.
Well, yes, but he screamed,
got all of the gay ones.
He left the room,
yes.
And he ran back... Like he won something, but what he did is he just listened to 12 awful Christmas songs. But since we added
I guess the top three or the four. Top three
I actually had that one on the list as an honorable mention tiebreaker.
If I had fucked up that No Doubt one.
Yeah, it would have been over.
I've been kicking myself for years for Christmas.
You and your real big fish.
Yeah
I know, right?
You're Johnny Unitas versus Joe Namath. You should have won.
Yeah, you should have won the game.
I called it, and I said fuck you in the newspapers and everything.
I was off to such a roll.
I had sex with the homie the night before. All right,
that's enough old football references.
Okay.
Okay. So you wanted to talk about your favorite Christmas song?
Yeah.
To give us a little. Happiness?
Okay, I have several.
Okay, so. Well, maybe we'll play one.
Yay!
And we can, Lantz and I can talk about how terrible it is.
Okay, one of my all-time favorites ever is Let Us Know. When I hear that song, man.
Oh, well, that's a classic.
Yeah.
You got Frank Sinatra singing that, or Dean Martin, Dino, singing Let It Snow. Yeah. I actually like Baby It's Cold Outside.
Yeah, there's another one I really like.
The original with, I think, Dean Martin and, what's her name? I'll look it up.
Right. I also, sometimes I like to hear Grandma Got Ran Over by a Reindeer, but once every year.
Boo.
You know, I don't want to hear it too much, but I do. I'm in the country. I love country. So when I hear, you know, Grandma Got Ran Over by a Reindeer, I just want to get my
danger. Is that what country sounds like?
Yep. That's what they sound just like that.
Dinah Shore and Buddy Clark actually did the original, which I really like.
And I'll Be Home for Christmas. It's another great one.
Oh, yeah. Well, these are classics.
Yeah.
Like, with old 40s crooners singing them. They're really good, I guess.
I don't like the newer versions of any of these.
God, no. That's why Sleigh Ride is on there with Debbie Gibson murdering it with Sleigh Ride, Sleigh Ride. It's fucking ridiculous.
What's your favorite Christmas song there, buddy?
My favorite's Baby It's Cold Outside.
I don't know. Because
it's about a guy trying to sleep with a girl, and she keeps saying that she wants to go home.
Count?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
Joy to the world?
No,
Ode to Joy.
Oh.
The Hallelujah Chorus, I guess.
Yeah, that totally counts.
Yeah, it's a Christmas
song. Or anything by Train Siberia Orchestra.
Yeah, they're pretty badass. Yeah. They sound like a metal freight train. Yeah. And that. What's your thoughts on the Metallica Train Siberian Orchestra album?
There's one? There is one?
That's good.
Not heard of that?
I haven't heard of it.
Miranda has.
Are you kidding me? I've never heard the Metallica Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
It's amazing.
I didn't know they did one. I can't believe
they did a whole album.
The only reason
I know a lot of their guitarists are guys that have been in metal bands that they pick up and they tour with them for a year or two and then they
move on.
Because they're like, hey, I want a steady paying gig.
Well, I'm...
But they, I didn't know they did a Metallica album, a tribute album. I didn't know.
So the only reason I know, well, the what turned
I just
me
know
on
the song from
the
Budweiser controller, the commercial, where it's like the famous like, with the Christmas lights
on
the house.
Home Alone. Home Alone is what you know. There's that one period of Home Alone where they play a train set.
They're not on Home Alone.
Yeah, they are.
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are. They totally are.
No.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, it's
they're towards the end.
They weren't around then, were they?
Yeah, they were.
Okay.
Right, John?
What the fuck? I can't find this on fucking...
Maybe I'm wrong, but John...
On Google.
Not...
I have the album on my computer.
Oh, okay.
But it's not...
I'll deal with it later, I guess.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Well,
maybe they
they're
didn't.
They're not on Home Alone. I'm
they're on
you.
Home Alone, right? Trans-Siberia Orchestra.
They weren't around,
I do have it.
Morsheborg?
Yeah, let's play a 9-minute version of Master of Puppets.
He's never listening.
Oh, my God.
If you ever want to hear, like, string instruments do songs, they're good. Oh, that's badass.
It's badass. It's not the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
It's a Metallica S&M.
Yes, it's the San Francisco Symphony. Sorry.
Cut the music!
I'm sorry about that.
I don't want to hear any more of this.
I messed it up. So you've heard of that.
I'm
wrong then.
Do you like that album?
Not really.
Yeah, I love it.
They had some good... Some songs work.
It sounds
some
badass,
songs,
though.
Some songs work and some don't, but, you know.
Yeah.
It's experimental.
Yeah, it's neat.
They were the first band to take a symphony and put it behind... You know what? Bands I'd really like to hear.
I knew they couldn't have been
them
once you said that. It just sounds like the Trans-Siberian.
I would like to see like a Iron Maiden with a symphony.
Oh.
With the galloping choruses.
It'd be pretty bad. Oh, Rush with a symphony.
Yeah.
Epic bands. Like Metallica with a symphony. I don't know if they need the symphony.
Kind of, yeah, I agree.
It's speed metal.
It's pretty epic.
How about Aerosmith with a
no?
God, no.
Dude looks like a lady. Oh, no. Oh, good. All right, well, let's wrap it up here. Let everybody off to their Christmas.
What band would be the worst with a symphony? That
okay.
Would be...
Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga.
Oh, by the way.
But she's like... You mean I can be whoever I want to be?
Okay, I've had enough of your Monsters Ball tour.
By the way, since we brought up my dancing in gay clubs several times tonight,
yeah,
if you want to see me reprise my role in Shea Bichet's, you know, erotic dance comedy,
yeah,
go to the Broom Street Theater on Willie Street in Madison,
Wisconsin,
January 12th at 10:30, and I'll be there.
All right,
I'm reprising two of my like things I did in the show.
Cool.
Yep, I do a hobo number and I do a Lady Gaga number.
So. All right, that's what made you think of it, Lady Gaga.
Way to go.
All right, Lance, you got anything to plug? If you order Japanese food downtown, you'll see Lance, possibly.
Yeah, yeah. We're in the downtown area.
That'd be amazing if somebody did that.
By the way, hey guys, I'll talk about it on the air, but I'm going to forget like 10 minutes after this.
Yeah.
We can have a stripper come on the show, by the way.
Yeah, you told me about this, and you never said anything about it ever again.
Oh, it's got to happen.
Yes, it does.
She wasn't a stripper. She was a house parent.
Okay.
Which is amazing.
I don't know what that means.
I didn't know this either until she told me. But a house parent, it's somebody who basically babysits these fucking crazy bitches.
Uh-huh.
And they like...
Babysits strippers.
Yes.
Okay.
They know when they're there, they set up who's going to perform.
So they're like the bottom bitch of strippers.
Oh, I've heard of this.
Yeah. They basically...
I've heard of this.
They're the wrangler?
Yeah.
She's the one that give some rides from the bars.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She
sees a lot. She's there every night of the week. Yeah.
I have a friend who is dating a stripper, and he said she called her her mom.
Yeah, they do.
Huh.
They always called her mama.
And
he's still dating her, huh?
No.
Okay, thank
Things
God.
Things did not end well.
Thank God. Oh, you'll have to tell
Things
this off air.
Things never end well with strippers.
No.
But,
mm-mm.
You know,
unless you're Lantz.
I had a question.
And you get what you paid for, and it was awesome.
I had a question.
Yeah.
For him, when I went out with him and his
stripper lady,
date, who was smoking hot.
Yeah.
And I was confused because her and her stripper friends were like, we're just going to go to the bathroom for a minute. And they were gone for like 35 minutes. And it was like, yep.
Old cocaine action.
And then they were dancing on the tables.
Wow.
And it, you know what was funny, too? When they went to dance on the table.
Yeah. They're not wearing underwear?
They were.
Oh, okay.
And I didn't know why they had to get on the table.
Because they like the attention.
I guess.
I'm not saying all strippers are like that.
I'm just
saying
on a stage. And she gets on the table.
It feels so quiet in here all of a sudden.
I think the other one, her friend, the less hot one that was with her, was like, I'm going to get on a table too. And she walks over and immediately sees the horror that the next table had vomit all. Vomit all over it with like a newspaper.
the classic newspaper cover up.
And she's like, oh, I'll just wait until you're done with this table.
Yeah.
So, oh, Jesus.
So, who's the stripper lady? Give us a little more info. Let's tease it for the listeners.
Oh, well, she worked there for a year and a half, and she's there are stories about her taking objects out of women. Yeah.
There's we got to hear all this.
There's stories about strippers pooping on men's chests.
All right.
And this is just like just there.
Don't give it all away. Leave her
No, I can't give it all away. I wish
boy.
I could. But there's many stories of her dropping and picking these girls up and all that.
Hmm.
And she told me a lot of facts I did not know about
strippers. All
right,
cool. We'll get to learn.
Oh, by the way, the strip club in town called Farsight.
I've never heard of it.
Yeah, you know, Farsight. You know, the one that Lantz went to?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Visions.
Yeah. So there's a hotel across from Farsight.
Yeah.
That
Farside?
Is honestly, they're in cahoots with them.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Lantz, why didn't you?
And for an extra, this is.
How much?
Extra $50.
What?
Only 50?
Yeah,
you
can
Lantz,
go
you
across
out.
The street.
You missed out.
And at Farsight, you won't get fired for it. But at, you know, at Smooth and Shiny, you will. Actually, Smooth and Shiny, you get fined for not taking your panties off either.
Yeah.
Like, you get fined for not dancing. You get fined for several things.
Yeah, they make you work.
Yeah.
I feel like some of the girls should leave them on.
Really?
It's like,
yeah,
you
but
know.
It's a full nude. It's a full nude.
It's
one.
Full nude. That's what you paid for.
I know, but, like, some of them look good. Some of them don't look as good with the. Panties off.
All right, let's not get into this too much.
Just
we'll
leave
wait. Soon.
We're gonna be able to talk a lot about this.
Yeah, we'll take a whole
if
episode.
All right.
If she actually ventures into this man cave and gets ready for,
oh,
the,
she will.
She
is,
will.
She also is super into the sex toys, and her and I had an. Well, I drove up to her with her. I drove
Miranda.
No, okay, no. So you know, I
you drove up with her.
I got a new car, right?
Yeah, you went
but
on a long
new
road
car
trip.
Was in Green Bay, so I asked on people on Facebook to help me out, and this woman who I have not talked to in 3 years was like, "Yeah, of course." So I hopped in this car with a girl I've not seen in a very fucking long time. And she had her husband in the back seat that was just basically sleeping the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
And she's in what that you would call a very open relationship. She will have sex with guys that can abuse her because her husband doesn't like hitting her, but she loves being smacked around.
Okay.
But her and I had a 2.5-hour conversation about Bad Dragon, which is one of the best sex toys out there.
Bad Dragon?
Bad Dragon is animal sex toys. So if you want a dragon penis, you can get a dragon penis, like an actual size dragon penis.
Oh, God.
If you want, like, a horse, they'll give you these dildos. They're like make
a horse-sized dildo?
Yep.
Really?
Well, you can't get close to the real thing.
Yeah, both the bad and, well, we honestly, her and I had an awesome conversation that we can kind of recap when she comes on. But is it, you'll love
yeah,
it.
Yeah, this is you'll love it. This is the weirdest
and
thing I've ever seen.
And she has giant boobs. Just giant. Like, she could...
Fake ones?
No, real. Like, ooh. These are mother of boobs. Jeez.
Huh. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
There's a dragon flying and ejaculating.
Yeah.
This is the worst thing I've ever seen. Into its own mouth.
What?
Yeah.
There are dragon penises all over this thing. I blow. Don't go to that Bad Dragon website. Oh, God. Okay, and with that, we're going to end this episode of Born in the 80s.
Merry
I'm your host,
Christmas.
John Rowe.
Merry
Christmas.
Everyone.
Your present will be a stripper on the show soon, if Tyler doesn't fall through.
Yeah.
All right.
No, it will happen. Ill that or we'll do Born in the 80s. I made a
Thank you for listening to Born in the 80s, part of the Little Podcast Network.
What's the matter, Theodore? You don't look happy. Why?
Babe, you know.
But you got all those wonderful presents for Christmas. Didn't you get what you wanted?
All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth.